Hello, this is a brief video explaining the features of iWorks Procedural AI Generator that you can purchase on my website at jjeverson.com. I've been wanting to do this for a while. I haven't had the proper setup, so apologies to those that have been waiting for this. I hope it still is somewhat useful to you. Okay, so when you download the product, it comes with these files here. There's a README text that you can read if you like. It explains what each of these files do. There's an iOutputs folder here with different i presets that I've already exported for you in case you don't want to use the i generator itself. It's just a bunch of textures. I believe they are these examples here, basically exported into Targa formats. There's a 1024 and a 2048 version. As I was creating the source files in Designer, I noticed the 2048 started to slow down a little bit, so I created a 1024 version. My machine's quite old, so I wasn't surprised, and I thought most people probably don't need an eye resolution at 2048, so I think for most purposes the 1024 should be sufficient. But if for whatever reason you do need 2048, you have both options here. It comes with two OBJs, a cornea and an eye basic, which is the inside. It comes with an FBX, which is the same files, just an FBX format, which I prefer, which looks like this here. It has an outside reflective cornea layer and an inside eyeball with the pupil and the iris. You don't have to use this model if you don't want to. It just comes with it. Just keep in mind that the elements that the eye generator creates are within this ring here. Like the iris itself is within here, and everything else is kind of outside of here. Obviously, if you want to put this on your own character, on your own character sheet, you'll need to copy these UVs and paste them over. So once you get your eyes placed on your character and you've retained the material names, I'm not going to go through how to do that in this. I'm assuming that you know enough about Painter to import your own material names and objects. But let's just turn this off here so we can just see the eyes. All I've done to the cornea layer is add a bit of reflection. We can turn that off so we can see it too. And then if you take this SBAR file and you drag and drop it into this window here, you can import it as a base material when the prompt window comes up. If you have trouble finding it, you can just type in I and iWork should pop up here. What we're going to do is we're going to click and drag that over to the layer stack. And by default, the UV scale is 3x3. We don't want that. We want 1x1. Most of the controls are over here under iris controls and iris post. You have your color profiles that you can choose from, dark brown to like a gray green. These three settings here of the collarette are mainly this interior detail of the iris. So by adjusting this, it's going to pull that detail out towards the limbus, or it's going to push it towards the pupil. It kind of stretches it though. The Y will stretch it on a different axis. The frequency is kind of like a level of detail. A lower number will give you broader strokes inside of there, and a higher one will increase that detail. Random will always give you a different result each time. If you like that particular one, you can save it. So like 72 for whatever reason. And then down here we have the iris post, which is pretty self-explanatory. We'll increase the contrast or the luminosity, saturation. The redness shift brings the outer red towards the iris. And limbus blur is kind of something you may or may not find useful. I found that for greater distances, you may want to blur that outer limbus more, or I don't know, just might be useful. I think that's about it. As always, if you guys have any questions, you can email me at jjeverson@gmail.com. I'd be more than happy to help. And thanks for watching.